right, welcome. What a year it's been, let me tell you. So, we're finally here. We're finally having a band concert. This is so great. I love it so much. Yeah. I can't tell you how excited I am to be up on stage again after almost a full year of, you know, just waiting things out and prepping and stuff like that. So, hopefully you've picked up a program walking in. I apologize if we didn't have enough. If you have a special request, like absolutely would like to have a program to remember these guys' first concert, let me know. I'll get you one. So we're going to start with beginning band. These guys have, let me tell you about the journey we've had, like, from the beginning of the year. When the school year started, we couldn't play. We had to have special band masks made for us to make sure that we weren't spitting everywhere, basically. Because band instruments, there's a lot of spit flying around. And we also had to have bell covers as well. Now, we made our own bell covers, but we had to have the masks specially made. So while that was getting taken care of, we couldn't exactly play. We had to play outside. And as you can imagine, the weather was turning bad because it was starting to snow. Also, when you practice outside, you can't hear anything. Just the sound just goes out. So it was really hard for us at the beginning, and you can imagine a student who is trying to learn a band instrument is just going through a lot. So we are small in numbers this year because we couldn't have sixth grade join us. We couldn't have sixth graders from six different elementary schools join us. And so we're small, but we're mighty, and we have pulled through, and I can't thank these guys enough for doing that. So without further ado, this is beginning band, and our first song after we play a concert B-flat to get used to this area. We've never been in the Civic Auditorium before. We're just going to play a quick concert B-flat to get used to the space, and then we'll start with When the Saints Go Marching In.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right, if it's okay, I'm going to send the beginning band to go sit back with their families. And next up, I would like to invite the Percussion One group for their bucket song. So, percussionists, would you make your way upstage and grab your buckets? You guys are going to go this way. All right, so here we have Percussion One. They are going to be performing their own piece called Recycling Trip on Buckets. So these guys are in their second year of band. They didn't exactly get to finish beginning band last year, so they've been real troopers also. And so this year for them, just as much as beginning band, has been a little strange. So we're gonna open this section of the concert with a small song called Texas Cattle Drive. Thank you. Alrighty. So for each group, intermediate and concert band, we only have two songs, and the reason for that is in the past, we've had rehearsals 5 days a week. At Taylor View, we are now on a block schedule due to COVID, so I see these guys less than half than I did last year. And I have to say, these guys have come a long way. These guys have, you know, they're in 90-minute classes, which is a long time for middle school students. So they've been using their practice time like crazy, and it's definitely showing. So I love these guys so much. The next song that we're gonna do is a really great piece. It's gonna feature mostly percussion, but it is the Curse of Tutankhamun. Not only is it hearing lines, but it's also sight lines too. So if you'll let us, we'll do that again, please. Thank you. All right. Concert band is third-year band. They've been with me for a while. So these guys are eighth graders. They're about to go on to high school. Hi, high schoolers. So this is our collaboration concert with IF. We usually do one every year. So concert band from IF will be joining us after we've done our two pieces, and we will be doing that pretty shortly. But to open our section of the concert up, we are going to do the theme from Romeo and Juliet by Camille Saint-Saëns, which is the beginning of an opera.
Thank you.
All right, for our final piece before IF comes on stage, we will be performing The Magic of Harry Potter. So this is gonna have bits and pieces from all 8 movies in sequential order. So it's gonna start with the first movie, it's gonna go all the way through the 8th movie, and then finally finish with the theme from the first movie. Some of my former students might remember us playing it. I know I've done it before, so, yep. And then after that, we'll be making some adjustments, so we'll need some time from that as well. All right, The Magic of Harry Potter.
Thank you.
would just like to acknowledge the people who had solos in that song. Our clarinet player, our tuba player, and our trumpet player. Yep. So, especially our clarinet player, she's been our only clarinet in concert band. So, she's pulled through very nicely. Yes. And Riley's our only tuba player, but you usually only have one of those. So. All right. So, concert band, I'm going to ask that you stand up again. We're going to make our way this way, and if you would excuse our mess, we're going to shuffle around just a little bit so that we can play our final piece with IFHS, which is the Avengers theme song.
Thank you. That piece is The Highway by Daniel Montoya Jr. And there's some things in that that are polyrhythmic, or however you want to word it, polyrhythms, or what's the other word?
Heart.
Okay. things in there where we conduct one way, but we're supposed to feel it another way. And to you guys, like, it sounds normal, but to us, it's like a counting nightmare. And nice job. The next up, we're excited to feature on solo marimba. This is Sevilla, Sevillanas by Albeniz. And we will feature Hannah Webb.
I love
you. Look at you, Miss Popular. So on, what is this instrument? Don't tell him. What is this instrument? So there's a professional player of this instrument that says, has on his shirt, it's not a xylophone. Okay, so I'll tell you that, at least. Okay, so by the end of the concert, I want you to know what that is. Okay, I'm not going to tell you. Thank you.
guys all practice for hours. I'm so proud of all of us and these guys. And thank you all for coming. I hope you enjoy the next one. It's a bit of a different kind of piece. And I won't say anything else. You'll enjoy it.
So this is a perfect time to talk because they are setting up for the next, and I don't want to say a whole lot other than she really has worked hard. And I have a little story for you, but after I tell the story, don't get any ideas, okay? But she's getting ready for college auditions, and that's part of her audition right there is tonight's concert.
Yeah.
So here's where you don't get any ideas. She asked me a couple of weeks ago, and we've been talking about this for a while. She says, Mr. Bull, because I'm getting ready for college auditions, is there any way I could practice a marimba at home? So she starts packing up a marimba, and then I start getting emails the next day. Mr. Bull, it went all the way to the music office, by the way, this message. Mr. Bull and music office, I think someone was stealing a xylophone yesterday because we saw people taking it we didn't recognize and you weren't there. I had to reassure them, yes, it's all part of the plan, don't worry. And no, it's not a xylophone. So she has worked so hard. And I want to give you just another idea of how hard she's worked. She's discovered a true love of hers within music. She's been a great musician, played violin and piano for some time now, for years. And thank you, Mom and Dad, for supporting her in years of lessons. But it hasn't been until September that she's played it. And now she wants to major in it. This is how hard she's worked. So, yeah. So we're very proud of her. I'm going to get out of the way for the next one. Thank you. What do you mean? I spent like $50 on that thing for you. Guys, we're pulling out all the stops. People that left, they don't know what they're missing. You ain't seen nothing yet. Let's give them another round of applause.
Thank you. That song was originally arranged by Leonardo Bernstein for the Broadway musical West Side Story. The song was to accompany a complicated dance number in the dance style Mambo. Hope you enjoyed Mambo from West Side Story.
Don't worry, it's mostly real. This is Burke. It's 12 days north of Hopeless and a few degrees south of freezing to death. We have charming views of the sunset and a nice village. But the only problems are the pests. Because we have dragons. Thank you.
That song was originally arranged by Leonardo Bernstein for the Broadway musical West Side Story. The song was to accompany a complicated dance number in the dance style Mambo. Hope you enjoyed Mambo from West Side Story.
Don't worry, it's mostly real. This is Burke. It's 12 days north of Hopeless and a few degrees south of freezing to death. We have charming views of the sunset and a nice village. But the only problems are the pests. Because we have dragons. Thank you.
arabesque is a form of artistic decoration based on rhythmic linear patterns, often combined with other elements. Samuel R. Hazel composed this piece, titled Arabesque, to replicate the mystical sounds of Middle Eastern music. With its dancing melody, please enjoy Arabesque.
There are some pieces we might have no business playing. That could maybe have been one of them, but we did it anyway. Man, they worked hard. I think you could tell how tough that one is, but boy, you can tell they worked on it too. Let's give them another hand.
Joining us today. It's truly an honor to have you at our concert.
Well, looks like they're happy to see us.
Well, they're definitely happy to see you. I can see you brought your Ammon phase pulse blaster.
I'm a Mandalorian. Weapons are part of my religion.
Would it be alright if I touched it? I'm a huge fan.
Easy with that. Hey, listen to me. Stop touching things.
Okay. Sorry about that. It's just so cool to see it live and in person. I can't seem to help myself.
No, don't touch anything. It's not a toy.
Okay.
Clearly.
Sorry again. Let's begin with a question about the series. Could you tell us a few of your favorite lines from the show that immediately come to mind?
I can bring you in warm, or I can bring you in cold. This is the way.
It's so cool to get to hear those lines in person. So, obviously, we've seen the show and want you to know we're your biggest fans. We'd like to take this opportunity to get to know you on a more personal level. Is that all right?
How do I know I can trust you?
I'll tell you what, we'll pare it down to just a few personal questions.
I don't like this.
Our sources say you have a pet bunny named Cupcake. Is this true?
Can we talk about this later?
What? I just want to see it. I just want to see it.
I don't have time for this.
My apologies. I seem to have hit a soft spot in your personal life.
Yeah, something like that.
We have just a few more questions. Are you still in contact with Grogu, also known as Baby Yoda? Do you regret your decision to let him go?
I did what I had to.
Well, we want you to know we are all inspired by your story, so we wanted to give you a little surprise. The good kind! The good kind! So, we are surprising you by reuniting you with Baby Yoda! We are providing you both with an all-expenses-paid trip to the Tatooine Resort by the Hutts. And while you've been here with us, a super crew of Jawas have fixed, detailed, and fueled up your ship. And while they were at it, they've also added, or have removed, some upgrades.
Thank you. Now it's not so bad. It's very thoughtful of you. Ready to lay low and stretch your legs for a couple of months, you little womp rat? Just like the good old days. This is the way.
This is the way.
This is the way.
Best $100 I ever spent. What instrument is that? The bass recorder. We have the Mandalorian. I know you took off on your ship, but could you come back real quick? No. Maybe he's just totally gone. We'd like to thank... Mandalorian, a.k.a. Warren Jones, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Cupcake. Don't forget Cupcake. That's the way, yes. Right. Gonna capitalize on that one. We're gonna have a guest conductor on this one. Ladies and gentlemen, Scotty Lightheart.
By C, sorry, that's an S, S Tvorum. It's a Ukrainian march, and I think the most interesting part about this piece is that it's been out of print for a very long time. I think it was since 1994. And just quite recently, this piece was actually edited and kind of brought back to life, so we're able to play it tonight. Also, along with this piece, against a traditional march, we're going to be having some singing from the band as well, so... Keep your ears out for that.
Thank you.
Who said my line? Watch your mouth. As highly illogical as this is, I would like to invite, as we turn on the house lights, our alumni that are in the audience to please stand. Logically, they forgot what you wear at concerts. I would expect nothing less, so that I can say this line. What are they gonna do? Fire me? Don't break character. Are you out of your Vulcan mind? Do we have an administrator in the room tonight? House lights, anyone? Stand so we can recognize you. Thanks for coming tonight. Thanks for supporting. Anyone? Logically, we'll work on that. Hopefully the next guy can do better.
No, I don't think so.
This is shorter than the last time I wore it. But you know how they dress these days. Anyway. At least it's not a red shirt. Jake Hansen, would you stand? Alumni. Avery Hale. This is very characteristic. Avery Hale on oboe tonight.
Hi guys.
Sloan True on percussion. Glad he's wearing clothes. Stand up, my dear. Kendra Anderson on trombone. Brenna Hale, trombone. Oh, oh, oh. Logically, I missed no one. And if I did, say no word about it. Are we ready? Let's beam it up. Yeah. thank you for supporting Love You illogically too. For it really does make no sense. I'm gonna capitalize on that one. Thank you for supporting your child or children through music and the arts. Vulcans don't cry. Maybe later. Yeah, you walked off with a cupcake. Don't even talk to me. Thank you again for all involved tonight. I'm truly inspired. Thank you for making me better. Thank you for being who you are. Keep going, keep growing. I love you all. Thank you for coming back. Some of you and my friends out there. Some of you look like you're in college. Yeah, long hair, beard. Booyah! Pandemic look right there. I sure love you. Thank you. What a great night it's been. One that I will treasure my whole life. Thank you. Don't forget to give us some money on the way out. I'll be right out there and ready to take some pictures. Yeah, because I'm dressed for it. So bring your child, children, and we'll make memories for another minute. Okay, thank you.
Woo-hoo. We're the best, yeah!